Good morning. Namaste. Good evening in US and good morning in early good morning in UK and good morning Sanjay Kala in India. In India always yoga taught in the early morning. So whereas in abroad everyone practices yoga in the evening. But now since why it is in the morning? Because morning, if you practice yoga, it is tenfold more effective. It is more tenfold more effective because of your melatonin, your neurotransmitters are totally balanced. So yoga is training the mind. That's the reason. And never in India evening yoga is practiced. Evening is only meant for, so only for japa, only chanting. And chanting and for doing dharana and only for meditation. The physical yoga, when we say it begins morning as early as like 4 o'clock in the ashrams, if some ashram 3:30 where I learnt morning, early morning 3:30 first jam. And so the earlier it begins, so that ashram is really strict. It means the late it begins means that ashram is not stricter. There is a criteria on which, you know, I used to get up in some ashrams at morning 2 o'clock. We got to attend my duties to keep the place clean for guru and the teacher to clean his place. So as a volunteer, I am always a volunteer. I am also a seeker. I am also a student, but I am always a volunteer. So that's how you get into the attention of the teacher. And teacher is not to get into the attention of the teacher. And volunteers would notice, each one of us in the ashram, how we conduct all our qualities. So you can check all my, in any ashram, wherever I worked, and one can check. And you know, so Kumar means they know. They can't find any fault with Kumar. And with respect to his service, with respect to his devotion, with respect to his commitment, with respect to his listening to the teacher, with respect to serving the teacher and serving the ashram selflessly. In many ashrams, I used to tell, it so happens some misunderstandings come and some of the villagers used to come and very wealthy families used to come. So, you know, so they used to threaten my teacher, you are abusing that, this. And I used to say, if you have to reach my teacher and first you take my life, that is a commitment. In any ashram, I had no money when I went to the ashrams. Means meager money, whatever a student has to pay. And that bare minimum money. And many times in many ashrams, I volunteered to clean toilets because that job is given. No one comes forward to clean the toilets in the ashram. So I always used to, whenever I used to go to the ashram, and if the ashram is very expensive, so then I used to make a request, is there any place to clean your toilets? And once you enter into the ashram to clean the toilets, and then once you, the toilets are very clean, they will ask, is there anything to be cleaned? If you ask, they will give you slowly, slowly. And guru asks, volunteer asks, sir, and never we found those bathrooms and those toilets are so clean. Who did it? Automatically in ashram your name will come because of your service, because of your work, because of your commitment, the way you do your job. Understand. And that's how meeting a teacher or a guru of any ashram is very difficult. We should never try. All that we have to serve in the ashram is volunteers. It is by volunteers ashrams run. And always I used to hold the feet of the volunteers. And even now I tell my students, the volunteers are the teachers. And if at all we have to respect not the lotus feet of the teacher, teacher foot as I told, teacher or a temple, you are not supposed to touch. Why you are not? Because you are not supposed to contaminate. You know. So that's why in Indian temples, people wear silk cloths. Because temple or a church or a masjid or a place of worship means place of clean. No virus, no bacteria, no dust, and nothing should enter over there. That's why in India the custom is, so one has to wear the silk sari, pure silk sari. And in India, wearing a silk sari tradition is not today's. You know, it It is thousands and thousands. So what is born the cloth in India is the silk. Before even cotton woven began, and it is the technology of the silk in India. And even my grandmother, great grandmother, I still remember. And on any, in a week, and at least twice or thrice, and there is always a good occasion where they wear only pure silk. Why pure silk? Because it is having highest electrostatic energy fiber, which we call today N95 mask and with electrostatic fiber. Why N95? Only surgical mask will work, because the virus, as you know, it is only 0.07 microns. 0.07 micron, any mask can stop only up to 0.3 microns. It is the highest level of that a mask can stop. This is called HEPA filter, 0.3 micron it can stop. High efficiency particulate arrestor. And where every pharma industry, every drug industry, and they are supposed to have, so not to let go of any molecules even at the trace level, they must have HEPA, and before HEPA they are supposed to have electrostatic precipitators. So that any part, first they get ionized and they will be removed from the air, and after the ESP it comes to the HEPA filter, then only it goes to the vent, it goes to the atmosphere. So the clean, dust free, bacteria free, protein free, any molecule free, air, pure air is let out outside. So our ancestors have given us the technologies. ESP means electrostatic precipitator, and once any particle passing through it, and in that electromagnetic field, and the particle gets ionized. The particles gets ionized, and when they get ionized, and they fall down, so they can't move anymore. So unionized particles only go in. So that's the reason why in India people always wear two gold rings here, and for the nose rings, earrings, and all the technologies, silver anklets, and armlets, gold armlets. It is to protect you from not only disease, to maintain your electrostatic potential, to maintain your cell membrane potential. If you really see the reasons why the inflammation or whatever you call, and whatever it is, and cell membrane voltage is coming down, pH is coming down, acidic environment is the reason. And when you say inflammation means, all these are inflammatory diseases. Inflammation means what? Acid. So acid means what? There is no oxygen. Oxygen cannot dissolve in acidic environment. So once oxygen is not available, mitochondria can't survive. So at the cost of mitochondria. That is the reason, always understand, acidic environment, when you drink an acidic environment means your capacity to dissolve oxygen is coming down. You are drinking an alkali means your capacity to digest oxygen is increasing. Oxygen saturation only will be increased in alkali environment. Why an athlete can't run an endurance, as I told you, lactic acid. Acid, it cannot, oxygen cannot dissolve in that blood, oxygen cannot dissolve in the water. So that's why, if you want to dissolve the oxygen, and that's how the technologies are given. So in India, it is electrostatic precipitator means, it is, so to conserve the oxygen going inside. And oxygen to, as it is, ordinarily 2% of the oxygen gets oxidized, burnt, whatever you are inhaling, every person except yogi is 2% of, by default, if there is no emotion. But if there is any emotion in you, or when you exercise, intense exercise when you do, high intense exercise, or when you are running, when you are jogging, when you are doing exercise to sweat, do you know, the 2% increase to tenfold, 20% to 40% of oxygen you inhale gets oxidized. The problem is, when it gets oxidized, so what does it matter, sir? Oxidized oxygen means they are called oxygen reactive species. A burnt oxygen means, oxidized oxygen means oxygen reactive species. In technically, they are called ORS. And these will damage the cell membrane, cell, and they damage, they are the reason to cause NK cell activity, natural killer cell activity, tumor necrosis cell factor, alpha activity, and it kills those, the cells which protect your immunity, the cells which protect your energy, and which controls not only cancer cells, and not only abnormal cells, abnormal organisms, but these will kill your protective defense system. These are your cells, T cells, which produces antibodies. And it costs this. Intense exercise, when you say it is 20 to 40% of oxygen is getting oxidized. In yoga, an intense exercise, not allowed more than 5 to 10 minutes. 5 minutes to 10 minutes, followed by every intense cycle of 1 minute, followed by again a zero resistance, normalizing the breath, because you cannot, your purpose of exercise is not to create free radicals. Radicals. People don't understand. And what a damage you cause to your system. This 2% itself is the reason for your aging. A monk, in fact, he enhances when you observe the same oxygen, and when you observe the same oxygen, not 2% get oxidized. If you observe those molecules sitting, meditating, observing the breath, or when you do in a zero relaxed state, when you do it, in fact, the oxygen potential increases because duality goes away. Duality goes away. A electron, once observed, it goes straight. Once observed, even from a distance you observe, and even you make a program. You make a program, it knows, electron is very intelligent, it knows that there is a program made to control it. That's all. If it knows there is a program, it won't even go there. It will go straight. You know? If your child knows there is a CCTV, or if your employee knows there is a CCTV, and immediately they conduct automatically. So electrons are like that. Like a human is a bundle of elementary particles, everything existing. So what is the reality of the elementary particle? That is the reality at the gross level. It is not that at subtle level some reality is different, at gross level some reality is different. So if you observe the nature of the elementary particles, as you go down, elementary particles, and as you go down, dark matter, dark energy, if you understand those at the experiential level, and then you will understand why we are behaving like this. Because we are made with the same electric circuits, same electrons, same elementary particles, same consciousness. So that's the reason to understand the phenomena outside. Our saints or the rishis, they explode at the micro level. At the causal level, at the consciousness level. At the consciousness level, it's not Vaisheshika Darshana given by Kanadi Mahamuni, means he is an elementary particle physicist. He is a physicist who is specialized in elementary particles. In subatomic, his name itself, Avaloka Mahamuni, he is called whole. Because and there is nothing can escape from his insight. He could observe every smallest of small consciousness. That's why he's called old. Old can see in the night, can see in the day. And his name called Avaloka. Avaloka. In Sanskrit, Avaloka means old. In fact, from old, you can see Avaloka. From Sanskrit only the word old came. And he is called Kanadi. Particle physicist, Kanadi, his name itself is a particle physicist, he is referred as a particle physicist. So yoga is all about understanding at the causal level, at dark energy, dark matter and singularity level, understand. It is not at the gross level, all our behavioral patterns, all our emotions, all our moods, they are nothing but molecules in motion. You are nothing but a molecules in motion. And those molecules, if you understand what those molecules are made up of, and what those sub-elementary particles are made up of, that's the problem is there. The duality is there, that wavery nature is there at that level. That's how entire yoga is observing, 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 and it trained to be with the unconscious mind. You know, when you do yoga, if the mind is not there, people listen to the music, and as per the music they are dancing. Their concentration is on the music. There is various observation. Yoga is all about pratyaksha. It is experiential. You are cutting off from the outside sense doors. Yoga is to cut off the sense doors. And when you are doing yoga, you should be there in that posture completely. Because every posture, what is your body? Body is a field of unconscious mind. Because from every part of your body, you are removing the impurities. Every cell is having your conditioning, as I told you. Even one cell is separated, an entire your person can be created. There's a reason, whether you do asana or a pranayama, or whether you do mudra or a bandana, or of the hatha yoga, or in the meditation, the goal is to purify every cell. Asana is to purify every cell in your body. But the cell gets purified, how many levels? Physical level, and at oxygen level, at cellular level, and at the mental, at the nervous system level, control level, at recruiting of neuron level, recruiting of locomotor level. That's why there's so many asanas, why so many asanas, so many style, because they are training your mind to be in every cell. And why yoga? There's a way. By default, your mind only wanders. This is a way we are training the mind to be in this moment in the body without any judgment. Whether you take asana or a pranayama, it is to develop awareness. It is to develop the capacity to observe uninterrupted observation, as Patanjali is uninterrupted observation. Then only the purification happens. Then only your neuron circuit starts functioning properly. Neurons are nothing but electric circuits. So that is the reason. And the mindfulness, mindfulness, mindfulness. And is all about not to get oxidized. And suppose you are tensing somewhere, you are listening. As I said, your exercise has become oxygen consumption. That is for a person, that is a soldier training, my dear, running in the streets. You feel must because of the testosterone, but your temperament has already changed. You are the most aggressive person. Whoever runs, whoever does high intensity exercise, they are not looking at their mind part. They have a short temperament. And they are highly egoistic. In fact, to boost that ego, they run. No, if I run only, I feel good. What do you feel good? Your ego. And you are burning inside, causing 20 to 40% destruction. That's why you have to eat more. Your 40% of oxygen is consumed. And not only consumed, it damaged so many cells. To compensate it, your food requirement goes up. That's why you have to eat more. And your nutrition has to be 100 times more required. Because the damage it caused by oxygen reactive species, you have to compensate, means you need to drink the best juices, the best fruits, and when you don't supply, and within no time, your body becomes stiff. You show me one body who exercises, whose body has a flexibility free. He can't even leave any of his limb, he can't leave free. Total tightness in every inch of the body. And our purpose is to, when a muscle is tight, when a cell is tight, how come oxygen will go inside? How come nutrition will go inside? Anaerobic pathways. Body is functioning in aerobic pathways. And because exercise is anaerobic, his body has become anaerobic. That is the reason. So why? And they wear out very quickly. Wear and tear. All those who run and all that athletes, sports people, their lifespan is only for at very young age. After 27, you are out. You are out. At 40 years, your lifespan is over because you have already consumed, you have already used all your capacity. You have burnt out. And since then, all the suffering, knee problem, this problem, that problem, this problems. That's the reason why high intensity exercise are not good. So gold is a given, electrostatic precipitator, HEPA filter, and silk. Why people used to wear the silk? Today, the tradition, even in the house, and when any festival is there, means that is a way to decontaminate the house. So a woman or a man, they have to wear the silk cloths so that all bacteria gets attracted and they fall down, they get paralyzed because of the electrostatic. They become weak, they won't damage. Silk cloths, even to the children, we have to wear the silk cloths, pure silk. And as we forgot the traditions, so we are prone to more diseases, and we are prone to, because we have become, there is no firewall protection for us. That's why viruses are attacking on us. All our firewall protections we have removed. And all our cloud protection is gone. So completely we are become. Other side, cloud computing we are developing. We are developing firewalls and cloud security we are developing. But inside we are damaging. So we should understand whether you protect outside data or not. But inside, how you protect what our ancestors have given us is very important. So when you are 0.3 microns, and I told you, so that other day, I just wanted to chant, start with the, so my teachers, Shankaracharya's, so the two shlokas, and one shloka I will chant today, because I have already taken a little time, but without, praying, without rendering my gratitude to the teachers, so there is no way I can start a session. So before I wanted to start, something came. Anything came, teaching is always spontaneous, it has to be. Because that spontaneity means present moment. Anything comes from the past, anything comes from the future, it will condition that knowledge. That's why your teacher has to teach anything spontaneous. Teaching has to be spontaneous. In every ashram, the great teachers mean spontaneity. Spontaneous, it has to be informal. A student should never know what he is going to learn that day. So that's how your brain is programmed for eventuality, a preparedness for change, preparedness for your adaptability. This is how your adaptability increases. And because life is like, has anyone expected the corona? No. So once a coronavirus like comes, everyone is shattered. Why we need to shatter, if frankly speaking? So what? For a yogi, but the one who lives in the present, it doesn't matter at all. And if for any exigency, for any eventuality, and for any volatility, so they are not. Nothing is volatile, and nothing is eventual, and nothing is complex. And he is always there with a smiling face to adapt to it. There is no need to scare at all. So this is the way a training of a yogi is all about. Informal, spontaneity, informal. The right brain is always informal, left brain is always formal. And we are underway. When you are listening to your guru, means a guru is training you to be creative, training you to be living in this moment, training you to be responding to the situation, not reacting to the situation. Our entire world is reacting, not responding. There is very less response. Few countries like South Korea, you can see, they have responded to the situation. So, and in India, we have done as on date 180,000 samples if we collected. And in Korea, they have finished already, a long back, they finished 2 lakh samples they tested. And what is the population in India? What is the population in South Korea? That's why now South Korea model is becoming a model to be followed in control of the coronavirus. And it is a Buddhist country. And they are closely guarded and they are highly committed. And there is a high discipline, technological front, they are very superior. So they used, when the time comes, they use their technology and to protect them. If you really look at the number of people died over there, or the way, so they are analyzing the problem, they are the first people to tell, hey, coronavirus negative means those who are quarantined, again when they observed, and again they have is becoming corona positive. So negative positive fluctuations are there. Now they are studying that. So we have to be prepared. The preparedness, the life is all about. When the death comes, can you tell? Suppose I am going in this moment on a car, in a car. My car can meet with an accident, I may die. So what? So my family is already prepared, for example. It doesn't matter at all. Even Kumar dies at this moment, nothing happens. If I think, you know, oh my God, if I die now, what will happen to my children? What will, nothing happens. Everything is already taken care. Dharma. If you really a yogi means everything is taken care. You don't have to worry about anything. And I see people are scared. Oh, what happens, what happens, what happens? Insecurity, because why it is there? Because you don't live in the present. And you are always thinking about the future. You are always thinking about the past. That's why you are so scared. I look at corona, it's more than coronavirus killing. It's the people's fears are killing them. And it's the time to calm down. Blood pressure, in fact it is the time to lower blood pressure, it is low, it is the time to calm down, soothen ourselves to become a yogis, not to become a rogi. Tense, stress, strain, now people are generating emotions and domestic abuse, all these things are coming out, it only indicates, you know, how weak the human is. So, those gurus, the training of yoga has gone into a different direction, it has become a body exercise. In the West, spirituality is different. And yoga means asanas only. Yoga is not considered as spirituality. All that spirituality in abroad has no meaning. You know that without yoga. If you don't know the yoga, and if you don't know the yoga, Yajnavalkya, Yoga Samhita, Shankaracharya, 84,000 asanas he ate it, and he practiced. So anyone, and today, and these groups are different. How come? Your training is all about, starts from, you know, so your physical training, you're training the mind to be in every cell. That's how your training begins. And conservation of oxygen by pranayama, conservation of oxygen by mind. These are the different levels, sophisticated levels of conservation of oxygen we are programmed. And asana is the first way to conserve. Alignment, balance, center of mass, center of gravity, everything is conservation of energy. And so we have converted that conservation of energy into a consumption of energy like a soldier. All our means of yoga, all our means of exercise has become a consumption mode. We are not understanding the very purpose of exercise or fitness is, the base of the fitness is, and conservation of energy. So that's why I said, how much less you eat, that decides whether you are a yogi or not. The food you take, eat itself will tell. Not what food you eat and how much food you eat. That will decide whether you are a yogi or not. Whether your exercise is good or not. Simple. Because anything you consume more, it will vanish very quickly. The Indian life comes down. Your cellular life comes down.
Vyomavad bahirantarastitamaksharam nikhilatmakam Vyomavad bahirantarastitamaksharam nikhilatmakam kevalam parishuddha ekamajanmahi prati rupakam brahma tattva nichayam vinichayam niratan moksha bodhakam pratare vahi manasa bhavaye vad bahirantarasteta makshara.
He went beyond a guru, my gurus, all that lineage of the saints, and Shankaracharya explaining what they have done.
Antarastetam aksharam.
All the 50 letters of the Sanskrit are called akshara, alphabet. English alphabet. In English you call alphabets, in Sanskrit you call akshara. What is akshara? The one which cannot be destroyed, which is immortal. Sanskrit, each word is meant for immortality, which removes your suffering, which removes your unhappiness, which cures you from the problem. It is called kshara, akshara, kshaya, akshaya, which is supposed to be decaying. What is having birth, death, decay? It is called kshaya, is called kshara. And what doesn't die, and what doesn't born, and where there is no sustenance, nothing, these laws are not applicable, and they are called akshara. And the one who knows the science of akshara, and inside
antarastitam akshara bahir,
and inside when you explore the field of consciousness, and by applying this sound of silence, and he has already experienced immortality, then he made every DNA, every least quantum state of energy has taken. There is no least quantum state, there is no entropy in every cell, akshara, already. And he achieved that goal of akshara, which he meant, which a language meant for, which a Sanskrit meant for, akshara. And he used it to burn everything. He used it to burn everything.
Nikila Atmaga.
And the journey upward, the soul into the spirit, into Holy Spirit. Now, Easter period is over. Yesterday was Easter day, and last Friday was a Good Friday, and now the Ramzan is going to begin. You look at the most auspicious time you are bestowed with to stay in home and to become a saint. Easter period means, and to take the second birth. And similarly, Ramzan means, and only to staying fasting and meditating to realize Allah. And now there is no need even to go outside. Staying in the home, and you can absolutely, you got a brilliant opportunity to meditate, to take your spirit to Holy Spirit, to take your soul to Allah or Tawheed. This is a time to do Jihad-e-Akbar. And every Muslim, and the Prophet tells, your life is only to realize the Allah. Your morning to evening, you have to only work for that. There's nothing else. You are only eating to live, to achieve Allahu Akbar. Tawheed, that is your goal. There's nothing else. Other religions will tell your livelihood is important, this is important, that is important, this is important. But Prophet doesn't give any scope. He tells, your morning to evening, are you meditating to reach Allah or not? Like me, like him. If only every Musliman means a kind-hearted man. Musliman means a kind-hearted, the one who purified Musala, the one who has purified with the water, the one who has washed off his sins, Musala, man, and a clean mind, the one who has. And entire prophet teaching is to become a kind hearted, a kind mind, and a Muslim speech. His speech is so soft, not hurting anyone and not harming any being. Because he is so clean, his speech is pure, his thoughts are pure, his body is pure. Not the dress is pure. He is called the very literal meaning of Muslim. And Ramzan or Easter period, say 40 days, or a Ramzan 30 days, or Shravana Masa, Bhadrapada Masa, you have excellent, so Kartika Masa, which meant for meditation, staying indoors. Now no one meditates. Meditation is gone. Meditation is not a prayer. Because of your prayer, you will get the meditation technique. Prayer is not a meditation. Prayer is to, just to express gratitude. And you have to sit like prophet, like Jesus, and going into a cave every day he meditated. Every day. And prophet entered into that level of fourth samadhi, fifth samadhi. That's why, and he could convey the message of the Gabriel to everyone. And a Mary Magdalena could see Jesus again came back, because she is at fourth level of jhana. She also is at that level of seeing a person. Fourth level of jhana. She is also an enlightened person. That's why she could see. And when she willed, others should see. Then only others could see. Until then, no one could see the Jesus. Hey, you look at. Because she has used her power, and everyone could see that Jesus alive. A immortal soul. So also the prophet, so also the Rama, so also the Krishna. They are immortal souls. And there is a period to and contemplate and meditate. People have forgotten the meditation means again. Meditation is a purification, not concentration. Meditation has become a concentration method. A concentration, mere concentration makes you successful. Mere concentration produces dopamine. Concentrate, but it goes the journey topward. It is all about not the concentration, it is about the purification. The purpose of meditation is not concentration, it is a purification. Concentration is for purification. Observation, it is not concentration. What you have to develop for purification is observation. There is a huge difference between concentration and observation. And purification. The goal of spirituality is for purification, whether you are a Christian, whether you are a Muslim, whether you are a Jain, whether you are a Buddhist. The goal of that saint, of that religion is purification. Only purification, not the concentration. Everyone is having concentration. Olympic, every player is having concentration. But it doesn't mean they are saints, they are yogis, they are a very excellent human with the human qualities. No. Concentration never given any importance. And that's why Vedanta doesn't talk about concentration. Now spirituality means concentrating. When you concentrate, yes, naturally ecstasy comes. There are so many ways you can produce the ecstasy. Even by drum beat, you can, playing to the drum beat music, and you can produce ecstasy. And that is the consumption of energy. All this concentration is a consumption of energy. That's why whatever the powers you get, they will damage. They will damage you. They are detrimental. So understand. So what he is talking about.
Nikilatmaka.
He knows the entire journey into the soul. And to the Holy Spirit. Nirbhana, Nirvana.
Vyomavad bahirantanastitam aksharam. Nikilatmakam. Kevalam. Parishuddha ekama janmahi pratirupaka.
You will not get again that guru, because he has only that life. There is no more life for him.
Ekama janmahi pratirupaka.
If you miss that opportunity now, you miss forever. understand. And God gives opportunities equal to everyone. And the one who is successful, one who is a hopi, one who is a happy, the one who experiences the singularity is the one who availed every opportunity. And the one who suffers, who has not availed any opportunity. And if you miss him in this life, you won't get, you may not get. Because all your prayers are answered by your God to whom you pray, he will send you only a guru. That's why he is saying, ekam janmahi pratirupakam kevalam parishuddham. And he teaches only the path of purification. Only ekevalam. He doesn't teach methods of concentration. He only teaches you to how to observe for purification. How good you are becoming every time. Your guru means how pure he is, whether he attained that purity or not, or whether he is still focusing, concentrate here, concentrate here, concentrate here, and eyes closed, you have a kick, are you feeling good? And even you take drug also, you feel good, and get lost in the ecstasy also, you swallow ecstasy pill, you feel good. Whether you use ecstasy pill, whether you use mantra, whether you use sound, what does it matter? The goal is not ecstasy of the which you get by concentration. The goal is by observation, peace, ecstasy, peace. Not ecstasy is a goal, peace of mind, balanced mind. Ecstasy has taken away your balance of the mind. Now we are running after, so from drug addict converting into a mantra addict. Spirituality is not to convert from one addiction to the another addiction. And a rock and roll music to Hare Rama, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Hare. Can you dance like me? You can't. Because I am holding it, I am not dancing. You should see if I dance in ecstasy, you will be amazed. You can't dance like that. No one in the world can dance. Because I have come from that root. And when I tell you, the ecstasy is not good. It's called dervish dances. It's a music. Anything, whether you take a drug, whether you take alcohol, whether you take anything, it is like a sedative. Or you take marijuana, you take heroin, whether you use mantra, whether you use sound, what does it matter? And the goal, if your goal is simply to experience the ecstasy, why to waste time? All of them condition you. All of them make you weak. A drug makes you weak, and now you get obsessed with mantra, and you know every day you chant, and every day you are consuming energy when you are burning like this. Do you think Saint Vasishtha and all burning like this, playing like this in the streets? Do you think? Do you think Saint Vasishtha is saying, Hare Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Rama, Hare Krishna? Do you think so? You will read first how composed they are. They are not jumping like monkey and to weigh their energies, consumption energies. The goal itself is different. And now people don't understand. Spirituality means jumping. Spirituality means entering into the ecstasy. That's how it has become now. And people are encashing like anything because people want to have that ecstasy. So why you go for ashram and why that slogging? Take a pill. Hey, pill I take, I addicted. So in ashram also you are already addicted to that guru. That guru, why you are addicted to that guru and teaching? Because of that ecstasy he gives you. And such people we should not even touch. We should not even go. That's why criteria is important. Now, I feel, I experience the energy here. Only here you experience. Is it to experience the energy or is it to lose the energy? It is to totally lose yourself and totally to see entire everything as you as everything, not ecstasy. It is a completely least state of ego. Have when you experience that, have you become egoless completely? Tell me. Have you become a transformed person? Check yourself. In fact, you have become obsessed. and you left your family, you did not care your wife, you don't care your wife, you don't care your children, and you know, you went like a mad guy, you changed the dress, and in the streets you are jumping like that. Do you think this is spirituality? That's called obsession. That's called possession. Don't get fooled by these intellectual talks, and don't get fooled by this kind of the technologies. Yes, they have the purpose. Purpose is concentration. Little concentration. But the concentration should develop observation, capacity to observe the reality, the truth. Concentration on any object, you can develop the concentration, observation of the reality. It is for that. Pravrutti dharma, nivrutti dharma. Conditioning is to decondition. Chitta vritti nirodha, it is to deactivate your memory. It is to transform your personality.
Kevalam parishuddham ekam janmahi pratirupakam.
You will not get that teacher again. Understand, what you have to look when you go to Aashram is the one who purified. If he talk,
yoga matma vishuddhaye esamagho vishuddhiya ekayana magho.
Buddha says,
ekayana magho. Yoga matma vishuddhaye.
The path leading to the purification of the mind. Always. The goal is only that. Purify, purify, purify. Not concentration.
Brahma tattva vinichayam.
The one who only talks about tattvas, 24 tattvas, from entropy to the elements, the one who purified entropy, ego state to high ego state to completely egoless state, selfless state.
Brahma tattva nechayam vinechayam.
He talks only about that, nothing else.
Niratanu mokshesu bodhakam.
Always he talks about only liberation, only attaining Tawheed, Allah, Holy Spirit, Parabrahma, only as a goal. Entire Veda talks about only Brahman, Parabrahma, Parabrahma, Parabrahma. Not intermittent stages. If you have to go to a Delhi and you should not get down in east. Intermediate stations are not at all important. When you are going in a train, so from one place to the other place, and so many stations will come, but you should know where you have to get down, what is the destiny. Our train is meant for, our vehicle is meant to go to the singularity. The one who takes you to that destiny and only hold on to him, not the one who stops in the intermittent stages and not, you can't, if you change the train, not necessary every time you get a connecting train at all. That's why, and get into a train, and which takes you to the destiny. The one who only talks about the destiny as a Allah, the destiny as a Kaivalya, the destiny as a singularity, a non-entropy, only that guru you go. Not the one who offers you this ecstasy pill, that ecstasy pill, the package. Okay, you do three exercises, and you do the three bandhanas, and so 2 minutes of rapid breath, and then keep eyes closed because prana is exhausted, and then you feel then you concentrate here, you feel good. Understand? That's not the goal. The goal is yes. Beatles left their music and they loved because sound they like, and they went behind the mantra. But that is not that won't take you anywhere. It is a method of concentration. Siddhis flying, like Ravanasuras, Ramas, Ravanasuras, demons they fly. Who will learn the techniques you tell me? No one will learn. Who told you? And people get just carried away by this legacy. They think this is the tradition, this is the ancient tradition, Siddhanta Vichara. Shankaracharya means he has not given those. So he has given these prayers to express our gratitude to every God, every angel. He has given a prayer because to express our gratitude, because they are our hierarchy, because of them the world affairs are maintained. It's a minimum courtesy to say thank you to them. That's why every God he identified and he has given a prayer. Prayer is not for meditation. Meditation is very clear, Advaita, singularity. What he told, singularity, all this, and you are a singularity. This is the center, this is the singularity, this is all entropy, all these are elements. Your goal is from here to here. And singularity controls everything. So there is only one singularity. So all the duality when you remove, you realize that singularity.
ब्रह्म तत्त्ववेने चया निरतानु मोक्षसुबोधकं प्रातरेवहि मानसान्तर्भावये गुरुपादुका.
Heartfelt salutations to those lotus feet and those lotus sandals. I am only eligible to hold those feet, only those sandals, not even feet. Feet are, you will never get a feet of a teacher. If you can only see the sandals outside, where you leave the sandals? Outside the house, in ashram. So your ability, you can, people who just want to take it granted, they can meet their teacher, guru like that. No. You only can have a glance of that guru. Those sandals represent guru, that's all. And maximum you can see, if you have seen those sandals, you have seen the guru. That's why Shankaracharya is not telling about you look at a guru or guru feet, only guru sandals. And my salutations is to guru sandals, because every day he used to see those sandals. The one who sees, worships the sandals only, can have that unquestionable, completely surrendered to the teacher. If you think, hey, they are the sandals, means you are in the head. There is no need to go inside. First you should know, those are only, all that you are eligible is only to touch those, to only pray those sandals, that's all. That's why in the temple for sandals are given. You are not allowed to go inside. You are not allowed to enter into center, sanctum, sanatorium at all. You are not, it is a priest who stays here. You are not allowed. You are allowed only outside the soul. Only souls, guru souls. Guru souls are worshipped because soul is in the soul. Guru soul is in the soul. If you understood, you understood. If you are not understood, you have not understood anything. My early morning salutations to those lotus souls. The lotus souls. And this is how every day at least one shloka we explore. So during this period, and how long, so this lockdown will continue and we will be able to give you, so this live, so if not live, we try to give you afterwards. You know, so very few people are watching, not more than 100 people are, you know, so maybe maximum 300, 400 people must be watching the live. We are lazy people, you know. So majority of us are, whenever whimsies and fans, whenever the mood comes, then I sit. And then so I go through this. And some of us, we don't even buy. Hey, it's, first thing you look at is time. Oh my God, it's 2 hours? Hey, don't look at it. Oh, 2 minutes? Okay, let me see. This is what people are encashing you, my dear. What you will learn in 2 minutes, you tell me. So, looking at the time itself, you don't want to look at. All my students watch, they know the value of it. But a new person, and it is a brilliant opportunity for a yoga teacher to get understand the intricacies. But how many Western yoga teachers are watching it then? By now, if they are watching, means now they could have been thousands and thousands of the views. Because our mind habituated for instant coffee, instant burger, instant fast food, which kills us. Not slow cooking. And you will only understand what is good is only when it is explained like this. Two and a half hours when you listen, then you will understand. What you will understand? It is not your strength. The moment you are looking at the time, you are leaving it. Same way, why can't you expect any movie you watch? A movie is it for 1 minute? A movie is 2.5 hours, 3 hours. Then the 2.5 hours, oh my God, it should have been little more time. Why? Because it puts you into delusion. A teacher is removing the delusion for 2.5. If a movie takes to create such a kind of delusion for 2.5 hours, and how come a teacher will remove your delusion in 2.5 hours, tell me. If a movie is for 2.5 hours, means a teacher teaching should be 5 hours. Easy to create the delusion, but to clean that emotion, when you watch that movie, you bond, your oxygen is consumed, you produce testosterone, you smiled, you looked at like this, you felt like fighting, and then you looked at the heroine and you want to, you produce the estrogen, you produce the testosterone, and all the chemistry and all your prana is conserved when you watch the movie, and you exhausted completely at the end, and because your exhaustion you feel movie is very good, and you eat, and you immediately, what happens, because you have consumed more, you feel like eating immediately. In fact, while watching itself, you feel like eating, because it shows how much prana, how much demand for oxygen is there, how much demand for energy, where your energy is gone for burning emotions, for producing emotions. And for me to remove those emotions and for you to repair those cells, so for me to repair all that stuff, how much time it should take? Does it take 2.5 hours? It will take more time. But you look at, you expect it to be deluded, to be conditioned, 2.5 hours you don't mind spending. But when it comes to removing your delusion of a yoga, and then you don't have time. It should be like a advertisement on the TV. You know, so you see ads on the TV, you know, so all those ads, few seconds only, 3 seconds, 4 seconds, 30 seconds maximum. Very 30 seconds, even 4 seconds, 5 seconds only ad span. And that ad influences you, and that 4 minutes ad captures your attention. For what? To consume, to spend your money. And to spend your money, to condition your brain. Anything that is small, it conditions. If it is 1 minute, means it is conditioning your mind. Deconditioning can never happen in 1 minute. Because your mind is attracted, sense doors are attracted completely. Hey, advertisement means very efficient. What you hear, what you see in WhatsApp, oh my God, this video of 3 minutes is so fantastic. It means it captured your attention. And it conditioned your mind. It touched your perception. It touched your taste. And that is our limitation, understand. So this instantaneous, spontaneous, this 1 minute, 2 minute. So yoga is to remove your delusion. In fact, if any guru teaches, oh, I will only teach half an hour. What he will teach you half an hour in yoga, I don't understand. For me, 2 hours, 3 hours just flies off like this. To explain one thing with examples like in an ancient method, you know, so in a traditional method, to explain each thing in detail, it takes so much time. Cause and effect, guru has to explain. Then only your delusion will go away. You just do this, and you just do this. What is that? That's our problem. You just do this. Are you a robot? You want to be a robot? And whatever, do I give you program how to function? You should know. Our yoga is to break that program of the autonomous functioning. Morning to evening, and you know, steering wheel, your hand is driving the steering wheel and your mind is somewhere, you are talking to someone. How much time? Not even 78% of the day you are in the present moment. Not even 1% of the time you are in the present without judgment. So that's why. And there is a way to train ourselves. This is a traditional method. And someone asks, hey, who will see 8 minutes, only 30 minutes? Understand the intricacies of yoga. Yoga is to decondition the mind. Conditioning we like, but deconditioning we don't like. What we don't like, writing examinations, studying, we don't like. But if we study only, we get good job. Isn't it? So yoga means, if you study very well, if you really work, ordinary for money earning itself, if you have spent so many hours of time in the classroom and so much struggle if you have to do, and do you think Parabrahma, Tauhid, Allah, just like that it comes? Without spending time, without studying, it will come, without working hard. And without working hard, have you got a gold medal or have you passed your graduation or a post-graduation? And this is much more than a post-graduation. And how much you have to work, how much you have to spend, if someone tells, hey, it is not required at all. How much study is required? How much understanding is required? How much practice is required? 24/7, a doctor studies, a doctor studies 24/7 to pass her medicine. An engineer 24/7 for examination before, he won't even sleep like a yogi. For earning the money for acquire a qualification. And if it is for this singularity, then how much work you have to do it? This is how a saint you will find, oh my God, so many years he practiced meditation and went on meditation. He went to this school, and finally he could get a right guru and completely enlightened guru. And then this is a criteria. By then he developed criteria to choose a guru. And what he is looking for? And he studied. How much time it took for you to understand, you know, the things which you are studying in the PhD? Tell me. It took 17 years. Minimum of 17 to 18, 20 years it went to understand one subject in the depth. That subject not even a depth, but to understand the depth of the reality, of the singularity, how much time it will take? Why, when I say 45 years, you may be saying, hey, I don't need 45 years. Yes, you don't need 45 years if you have a wisdom like a Nachiketa. But otherwise, very difficult even for you to, whatever I'm explaining, how many of you can appreciate, how many of you can understand? Very difficult. Because it is absolute standard, it is absolute truth. A guru speaks always truth. Candid, articulate, there is no diplomacy in Guru. Who feels what one feels? No. Straightforward. Shankaracharya or a prophet or a Jesus, never scared of anything, anyone. They speak only the truth. I am not here to pamper you. I am not here to divert your attention. I am not here to please you, to make program or a package for you. It is a training. And for us to protect from, like the coronaviruses, in future, so many are going to come. So many are going to come. Do you think this is only a test? This is only a beginning. You know, what you are seeing in Corona is only a beginning of the war. You know, what nature can do, it is showing. If we play with the nature, with the 5G technology or 4G technology, it is only a beginning. In this war, only one will win. The one who has a firewall protection of yoga and the one who understands himself, the one who is strong, will survive. The one who is weak-minded, the one whose defensive system collapses and he has to give up. Simple. It doesn't matter what qualification you have, how much money you have. You can see coronavirus is taking away all those with high qualified people and high name people only it is taking away. You can see how vulnerable they have become. Understand. Then what at the end we are achieving it. So when I explain, I am explaining something concept, it is the traditional aspect, it's not that I am trying to. Why am I teaching like this? Why no one is teaching like this? Why is this 1 minute, 2 minutes, 15 minutes, half an hour, online teaching, so selling the packages? I am not doing that with you. Isn't it? So understand. Now, So I read that shloka about the Guru every day, one shloka, and when I explain word by word, you will understand. Today, what you understood? What is the akshara? Kshaya, akshaya, akshara, akshara. A ball is called akshaya. You have to go to the hold the ball in front of the teacher. You have to adihi bhagavo. Adihi bhagavo brahmeti. Oh teacher, what that doesn't destroy, give me. What that does undergo destruction, change, give me the technology. Is what you have to ask. That ball, the same ball when it got empty, the same ball you have to hold in front of a monk. Oh ball, my ball is empty, let me become empty. And what is the way out? How to become empty? And how can be akshaya? How I can attain that immortality? What is that you give me? What I have given you is a very small thing. That is only food. It goes from here. And it comes out from here. It is only this body also. What that food prepared this body also not permanent. After 120 years, this body is out. So that's why this food has no importance. What I have given you is so peripheral, so impermanent. I am giving you, it goes like this, it goes out like this. Even this body which is taking it will vanish just like that. So give me something which is permanent. And give me some technique which lasts forever for me. That is what every Lama every day reads, every Tibetan every day he reads. Om Mani Padme Hum 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 Adi Bhagavo Brahmeti Adi Bhagavo Brahmeti Adi Bhagavo Brahmeti Om Mani Padme Hum 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 Om Mani Padme Hum 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 Om Mani Padme Hum 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 Om about citric acid, about lemon, how much lemon, and what is sodium bicarbonate, baking soda. So today I told you, I will show you. So this is the Merck pH paper, which checks the pH. You can see the color index here. Use only standard a pH paper. The Merck is which supplies standards, standard molecules, 100% pure molecules for any peptide. If you want to get a 100% pure peptide and sigma or HR, you know, everyone knows Merck, very expensive. So also the Merck pH paper, and don't go by an ordinary quality at all. And go at least the standard of the Merck, and this is your, because it won't, it is to play with your body. And so you can see this is the color of 4 pH and this is 7 pH and this is a neutral color and 8 pH and 9 pH, 10 pH. And this is how it looks. So now, as I told you, and one scoop, this is a half teaspoon and this is a one full teaspoon. If you really look at it. So now, and this is a glass of water, 100 ml water you are supposed to take. And this is a lukewarm water, hot water. And you can see, so this is a measuring. And in this is a jar of 120 ml, 100 ml. So here is a 100 ml mark. And I'm keeping in 100 ml water. So no parallax error. And a little bit more. And 100, exactly 100 ml. Now 100 ml, so now as I told, first half scoop we will dissolve. This is sodium bicarbonate. This is sodium bicarbonate. And you can see, in fact, measuring glass you can take. So let us go by criteria of spoon. So it is half teaspoon. It is written here half teaspoon. And I am keeping half teaspoon. So again, you may say it is a flat, not heap. Consider little bit more. And half teaspoon I added. Now, you see, it is completely already almost dissolved, you can see. And what comes out is carbon dioxide. That what you see, the air coming out, is a little bit of carbon dioxide. Already it's not dissolving in the water. And now it dissolved. You can see that it dissolved. It dissolved. There is no solidate at all. Now it dissolved. If it is a glass, it could have been good, so you could have seen transparency. But it is opaque in nature, so you can't see that, so always the demonstration vessel should be transparent. But still you can see the same opaqueness on the top and down is the same you have. Now, the next one is, so now let us check the pH. Because we have dissolved sodium bicarbonate, what's its pH? And so let me keep it here. And let me take a piece of paper like this and cut it like this. Always keep it away, and the way you have to keep in the pack also, so it should not be always left out outside, because environmental air elements will change. So the pH of this color of this, that's why it should be always inside, and at a time you only have to take out only this much. And now check it. And now, so let me check the pH. You can see the color of the pH. So you can see 8 pH, it is around 8 pH. You can see the color and which color it matches. It is between 8 to 9 pH, 8.5 pH. It's not 9 pH, so it's 8.5 pH. If I add more, so at a half teaspoon, the pH is around 8.5. You can clearly see. So alkali, this is 8.5 pH alkali, the sodium bicarbonate is too high. As I told you, it has to be 7.35, between 7.45. So now, so this is too dark for us to go. So that's why, now let us see how it becomes 7. Our job is to become little more than 7, and 7.35 to 8, in between this color we should bring. So now let us add lemon juice. So what you see, here is lemon juice. This is the lemon juice, fresh lemon juice, fresh squeezed lemon juice. The lemons are lemonoid, or you use whatever you use. And the criteria is how much acidity, citric acid it is having. That only you will know, that only you will know with the pH paper exactly. Because if it is really concentrated, so very less is required. If your variety of the lemon itself is diluted, so you need to add more lemon juice. That's why I can't tell you, you add only 1 teaspoon of lemon juice. No. Because it's a pH sensitive, so, and the acidity or the percentage of citric acid changes from lemon to lemon, season to season, enormously. That's why never be under the impression same lemon. Lemon is not the same everywhere in every season. That's why your criteria of the quantity of the lemon, yes, that is fixed. It won't change because it is a factory produced sodium bicarbonate, baking soda. So it won't change. But this is nature produced. Nature produced never consistent. It varies with the geography, it varies with the earth, in which climate. So many factors play a role. That's the reason when you choose your vegetables, fruits or herbs, from where you get those herbs for your oils, that is important. Because every area is not the same. And every time it is not, so that's why you should know precisely. Honey means from where you have to procure, and particular oil, say for example tea tree oil, means from where you have to procure from New Zealand. So like this, for every herb there is a criteria. A ginger, the best ginger in my state Nizamabad, the best turmeric like Kerala, and best cardamom, so forest cardamom in Kerala, not the grown, not cultivated cardamom. Cultivated cardamom is called 12 mm. So you should know. So that's why I'm just trying to tell you. A simply lemon means, so don't go by 1 teaspoon of lemon juice, I can't tell you. I could tell sodium bicarbonate exactly 1/2 teaspoon. But lemon it comes to, now let us see how much this concentrated and lemon juice is required to neutralize that. So let me add little. Let me use the same spoon, let me use this or other spoon I will use it. Because this spoon I used it for sodium bicarbonate. So I don't want it to get contaminated. So let's see. So you can see little bit I have taken. A small amount I have taken. Citric acid is very powerful neutralizing. So now I added into this. You can see there is a small reaction. And you know, so then let me add. So let me mix it. And let me again check the pH. So don't be in a hurry at all. Let me check its pH now. Again, let me take a small piece of paper. And what happened to it, let us see. And still it is having a high pH only. You know, you can see still it is a high pH only. You don't have to see. The moment you can see it is 8 pH. So citric acid, the lemon what you have added is about half teaspoon is not sufficient. Now I am adding more than 1/2 teaspoon, another 1/2 teaspoon I am adding. Now, so let me mix it and let me again mix it. Anything nature gives always holistic, that's why don't use artificial citric acid, use always lemon juice. And everywhere in the world you get at least lemons, that's not a problem at all, you know. And because artificial citric acid and it only comes with the citric acid, doesn't come with the bioflavonoids, etc. A lemon comes with minimum 35 phytochemicals. So nature gives in a holistic form, not harming way. So now the pH has come down. So it looks like now it is not really. So still the pH is high. Still it requires. You can see how much lemon is required to add. Almost, you know, so one teaspoon and then quarter lemon juice I have added. Now I am adding little more. Now let me see. Now, has it become now acidic? 7.35 should not become acidic and it should become 7 pH. Now, approximately, it is slowly you can see the first one and second one you can see. So, the pH paper you can see. You know, so, still it is more than 7. And still I have to add just 1/2 teaspoon and baking soda. And you see how much lemon it is consuming. And it is a concentrated lemon, let me tell you. And it is a good variety of the lemon. Still it is consuming so much of. You can see this. Now, let me test it. Still it is more. No hurry at all. You can see the reaction. There will be slight color change also once it neutralizes, but we are not going to completely 7 pH. It is still little more. I have to add little more. I have added it. What you have to do is better. You cut small pieces like this. That's what normally we do, like this. You know. So every time you don't have to, because sometimes your hand, your finger pH influences it. Now let's check. And so further, it is between maybe 7.45, 7.5 pH it is. Let me add a little more. And now let me mix it. And then let me see. Now let me take the pH paper and let me check. Now, so it is 7 pH almost. Yes, it is 7.35 pH. At this pH you can see, you can take it as 7.35 pH or 7.5 pH. 7.45 pH. Our range is between 7.35 to 7.45. So we have taken 100 ml and now it is and 120, so 100 ml almost about, it has taken about 15 ml, 20 ml here, scale is 110 to 120 ml it is, and so I have used more than 10 ml, almost 10 to 15 ml of 15 ml of lemon juice, you know, I used it. And now this is 7.35. So this is very good to drink every morning or night, evening, empty stomach in the morning. Like as I said, honey or this. But honey, understand, honey is having acidic pH, 3.2 to 4.5. Indian honeys are acidic pH, 3.2 to 4.5 pH it is. It is not alkaline. So that's why lemon and bicarbonate is excellent formula, so to use it. So this is for, and bicarbonate, as I told you yesterday, what is a bicarbonate? You know, the water also, you get the bicarbonate in the nature, spring water. When you take spring water, quality is decided by bicarbonate ions, and all other main minerals should be very less. That's why invariably a spring water measurement, you should see on the label is bicarbonate. 250, 350, 150, 350, 250, 350, 450, 550. The higher bicarbonate, it's good. And it is naturally, it's coming. Naturally coming means it's coming from limestone. It is coming from, you know, so the, like in Himalayas, you know. So bicarbonate is very high. Because of that, the water pH is alkali there. And it has so many good minerals in it. So that's why bicarbonate water, you know. So this is how, so your water is, you know, so this. So now you prepare your own bicarbonate water like this. And the pH balanced. So if you drink it, it won't bloat you. It won't bloat you. And allow it. So mix it thoroughly. Mix it thoroughly. And allow it for some time like this. So let carbon dioxide completely go away. And then you can drink it. And you can just drink it. You can drink it. Once again, let me check. Yes, perfect. So 7.35 pH. So this is the way you have to look at it. And this is the way you have to do it. You know, for half a teaspoon, it took almost, so more than two and a half teaspoons or 3 teaspoons of lemon juice is required. More lemon juice is required for less sodium bicarbonate. So the nature's way of neutralizing requires more quantity. But then it won't harm you. So this is how you have to prepare your lemon and your bicarbonate solution. It keeps your motion free and it keeps so many ways it will benefit you enormously. It can be your regular habit also. There is no danger at all. Because whatever the amount of bicarbonate required only, you kept it inside. So at least for the COVID period, it is like this. 100 ml twice a day. Twice a day, morning and evening, good enough. So now, so since I prepared it, so myself, I will drink it. Taste is like, you know, how it looks. The taste is, in olden days, you know, in India, we used to get soda. Soda means, so a bottle with a neck, there is a glass ball in the neck, and then, so you have to poke, this thumb you have to take, you have to press that ball inside and then carbon dioxide gets released. And that is a soda. That is, in India, everyone used to use that because after the meal, so they would have soda for the digestion. Soda for the digestion. So it dissolves and it pumps carbonate ions. It pumps carbonic acid, carbonate ions. So this taste is exactly like that soda because in India, everyone knows what is the soda taste. So that's why when I tell you, so lemon and sodium bicarbonate mixed, it becomes a soda. and it is exactly the taste of the soda. And this, if you want, you can refrigerate it. You can refrigerate it and then you drink. It is a much far better cool drink. But during the coronavirus, I tell you, drink it warm. Don't cool anything. So if it is summer time, it is hot. A non-corona period, you can drink it cold. But this during this period, better to drink everything warm. Don't consume anything cold. Soda. I am drinking again after a long time. Soda. During my childhood, when you feel thirsty or when any imbalance is there in the stomach, you always neutralize, alkalizing. That's why we used to drink carbonic water. But that is little bit acidic, not. This is 7 point, this is alkali, 7.35. It won't produce any negative reactions in the body. If you drink only sodium bicarbonate, it will create a lot of problem. Lot of inside, lot of gas it will create. If you drink only lemon, your teeth will go away. Because it's too acidic, teeth will go away. So if I have to check pH of, say, you know, so bare lemon juice, you can see. You know, if I have to check only lemon pH, you can see. Have you seen how red it is? Means 2 pH it is. It's a 2 pH. That's why never drink lemon juice directly like this. So this is a way to, you have seen that how blue color it is, and you have seen the lemon how acidic it is. It's a 2 pH. Can you imagine 2 pH to, what is the change? 2 to 3 pH means what? 10 zeros. 10 zeros. 10 zeros. Now it's a 7 pH to 2 pH means 50 zeros. 10, 10, 10, 10, 10. 50 times concentrated it is. 50 times concentrated it is. 50 times concentrated than now the drink what I had. That's why your teeth will go away. And when I say this is, similarly this is say 14 pH or 13 pH or 9 pH or 10 pH when I say, means it 30 times other way around. That's why neither this is good, nor this is good. Not this is good. Red color is good. So it is always important. And the pH, entire body functions between, intracellular pH should be between exactly, cell membrane pH has to be 7.35 to 7.45. Your blood pH has to be maintained at 7.36, 7.36. And of course, body is struggling to maintain that, because that's why our alkali reservoirs are depleted, our bicarbonate reserves are depleted, because of our excess consumption of acids. So this is a way every day. Homeostasis balance, your pH balance, you can do at home every day morning. So this is very helpful. There's a reason, because yoga is all about experiential. You know, so once you see it practically like this, it's easy for you. So buy one pH paper, a good standard. As I told, not many people know. So the Merck is the best pH paper. I rely upon the Merck pH paper than even an electrode. Because electrode varies. Every time you have to calibrate it using a buffer solution. There is a danger when you prepare in a buffer solution. There are so many chances of errors in a electrode method of checking. You know. So the best is in the home. The best way to use is the Merck pH paper. Don't think I am working for the Merck company. Merck training, formulations training I have undergone when I joined, my first profession when I joined in 1985. And that company has sent me for the Merck and formulation, because it is a pharmaceutical company. I was sent for a formulation training and 3 months. And in the 3 months I scored the highest in all the subjects. And in fact they offered me the job, and you know, I didn't go for that job because I attended the training on behalf of one pharmaceutical company. And so I served that company so very devotedly, and another company, so I switched over because that company closed. But the training and that formulations training and in my life, I never thought it would be useful, but now I realized for last 2 years, 3 years, now it is helping me to formulate the best of the nutrition and the best of, you know, the stuff to go into the phytochemicals, to go into chemistry, to go into high standards, so that I could formulate many things. And the credit goes to the Merck formulation. That is the best, you know, so the training centers in the pharmaceuticals, if at all, if one has to go. And so like that, I am telling you, so it is not the Merck product, I am promoting a Merck product, but I would express my relationship with the Merck company. You know, so why? Everyone in the pharmaceutical industry knows what is, which standards they use for peptides or anything. So anyway, that is a little bit of scientific mode. Anything is a good standard only you choose, because it has to do with our life, it has to do with our health. Don't just dump any nutrient because simply looking up everything in the organic shop, don't believe it is an organic. And don't believe it is superior quality, don't. Know the specification, know the standards, and then no one can cheat you. No one can cheat you. But remember, every moment we are getting cheated by movie, by advertisement, by cinema, by package, and by the companies, by the one who is selling, everyone is cheating us. If you really see, because they want to make a profit, they simply want to sell. They tell lies. Satyameva nanrute, where is the truth? Where is the truth? So that's why be clear, don't go by name and fame, don't go by the brand always, go by standards, standards, standards. Pramana, Patanjali says, Pramana, why you are in MS? Because you do not know the standard. That's why you are cheated. For everything there is a standard. For every input you give to this mind body, there is a standard. For this cloth, there is a standard. For the button, there is a standard. For the microphone, there is a standard. For the watch, there is a standard. For watch strip, there is a standard. For everything is a standard. If you know absolute standard, no one can cheat you. And you are held. Standards means they protect you. They conserve your money for the quality. You will get the best quality, and that is at a reasonable price at what you are getting the lowest quality. Understand? And that's why everyone is interested not in your health, my dear, everyone interested in their profits. You know, understand? So we need to help ourselves. Very, very important. The product quality, never question the cost. Always look at the, ask for the product specification. You can inquire what that product cost. Always, anything you take, even sodium bicarbonate, as I told you, it has to be a pharma grade. It is not just a food grade. Food grade is not sufficient, I tell you, because if I am telling you to use it, buy USP grade or use IP grade or British Pharmacopoeia grade or IP grade, at least, if not bioproduced bicarbonate, sodium bicarbonate. If not, it is pharma grade you buy. And the best is USP grade. And then the BP grade, then the IP grade. Certain ingredients, IP grade is the best. For example, now hydroxychloroquine is there. IP grade is sufficient. But now US, we are importing, they want USP grade. Yes, our companies will manufacture USP grade and give. That's not a problem at all. Because stringent, the quality parameter that they have to undergo. Not only simply that. And USP grade, when you say, qualify. If your time permits, if you have a lab, you can even send it for the lab. Then you can, you know, you verify. Rutam Vadishyami, you have to validate it. You have to verify it once in a while. Because I make these formulations, so I can't take chance. I must send randomly the sample for the analysis. Whether it be raw material or finished product. So to know exactly the quality is there or not. What yoga teaches you? Only standards. Your living should become scientific. Your living should become standard. No one can cheat you. That's called delusion. Because you are deluded by the advertisement, some cinema hero, some cinema heroine, and some sport personality drinks. You think they are drinking that? You get fooled. that's the way your mind is getting conditioned. Simple truth, that is. And we are not slaves. And just simply look at this and, you know, go like a dummy, like a sheep, like a cow. Yoga is to make us independent. Thinking becomes independent. Thinking becomes scientific. Thinking becomes research-oriented, project-oriented, exploring-oriented, practical-oriented, reality-oriented, reality-oriented, not living in some myth, not in delusion. Reality oriented, accepting the reality. No idealism works. We always live in fantasies of idealism. I want a heroine like this, I want a hero like this. There is no hero exists, there is no heroine exists. You know that? It is only in the cinema for the 2 hours. Neither that hero is a hero nor that heroine is a heroine. You know very well. It is only action to add up. But the life is not action. Don't delude your life with the delusions of hero, heroine. That is a deluded characters. Your wife is a reality, your partner is a reality. The problem comes because you are deluded there. You want wife to be like the deluded character. How is it possible? Your life is your wife the way she is. That's why train your mind always to be reality. Never idealize. Idealism is a delusion. Realism, reality. What is reality? Only you have to train to appreciate it the way the reality is. The day you are trained to accept the reality as it is, that day you are free from unhappiness. If you resist to that reality, if you don't accept the reality, means you are not adapting to that reality, you are becoming weak. Instead of trying to change the reality, and a bird is not trying to change the reality of the environment, and in UK or in Arctic also there is a cow, there is a crow, and there is a crow, and even in UK also there is a crow, and in Alaska also there is a crow, and India also crow. And so it's not that like us, they have not constructed, you know, air conditioning and atmosphere. They have not changed the reality. We have changed the reality living in it. That's why we are vulnerable, we can't go out. The same crow surviving happily for millions of years in Arctic and in Alaska, and the same crow is surviving in UK, the same crow is surviving in India. Why? They have accepted the reality, they have adapted to the reality. If you accept the reality, and it is a little bit of troublesome, but adaptogenicity automatically comes, and it developed more feathers. A crow in Alaska developed more feathers, and a crow in Hyderabad, in the city where I live in, did not develop those thick feathers because it is not required. It has a thin wings and thin feathers because it wants to lose heat here. It is high heat. There it has to conserve the heat. That's why it has a thick feathers. So for us also, and if we adapt to the reality, always anything that is not reality, don't even watch it. Don't even read it. Don't even read it. Don't even watch it, because it is deluding you. That's what Patanjali is saying. Viparyayam, already you have delusion. Enough delusions you have in the mind. Your job is to get out of the delusions. Work with the reality, work with the reality, work with the reality. Satyameva nanrute. Only working with the truth, only working with the reality. If that is your way to function, that is the criteria to choose, then you are healthy, you are happy. Entire yoga is to remove the delusion and to ability to see the reality. That ability to see the reality is called darshana, observation. Ability to see the reality is called jnana, jnana in Sanskrit, jnana. And Buddha calls it insight. Jnana means not knowledge. Jnana yoga means insight. That insight leads to the skill, wisdom. Insight only develops the wisdom. Jnana. In Sanskrit it's called jnana, jnana. And so Buddha calls it as a jnana, jnana. There's no different. Jnana. In Sanskrit it's called jnana. That's all. There's only jnana yoga. It is not jnana yoga. It is a jnana yoga. And it is raja yoga. You know, even you are using jnana, I mean yajna, it is a burning. The insight so burns you. That's why, and Buddha simplified it, he called it the nana, 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 developing. Practical, nana means practice, practice. Dana means nana, nana. So what discriminatory knowledge, what is real, what is not real. You know, so what is out of, you know, many, they are the vital few, which you have to choose. You know, they are useful many, but they are only vital few. You know, so that is called a law Pareto. So the life is all about, so it is all about reality, it is all about standards, it's all about truth. Not getting diluted, not getting diluted. If you only know the specification of your shirt, your pant, what you wear. If you only know the specification of this, this is a microfiber. This is called microfiber. Microfiber of what GSM it is. Why it in this cloth? So it helps any glass or anything it can clean, and without, it won't stain it, and it quickly dries. It quickly absorbs the water. It quickly dries. This is the most modern fiber, synthetic fiber that is produced by the science. The microfibers mean 10 to the power of minus 6, so it is, you know. So that level is a micron, and at that level the size of the fiber is. That's why the technology, you can use it blindly if you want to, after cleaning the vessel, after cleaning in your house, your kitchen utensils, after cleaning, what you should do after washing, you must keep the cloth. The best cloth is the microfiber cloth now. You must use microfiber cloth, so it won't leave any stain, any residues of your detergent or the soap solution on your dish. The big problem is when you clean your dishes and the soap solution left out, unless you are using a dishwasher, sophisticated dishwasher. If you are using cleaning the manually your vessels, utensils, after eating the plates, etc., you must wash it, and then you must clean it using now ultrafiber cloth. So that it won't leave any residue on the surface of your kitchen utensils. The any stain means what? Any heavy metals or unwanted things are remaining. And many household I see, when the plate is kept, I see those stains. You know, those stains. So because they are not cleaned. Many people just wash it and they just keep it there. You should never keep it just like that, because the stains go into permanently, they get sunk, they get absorbed. And that's why, as soon as you clean, as the surface is wet, when the surface itself is wet, use 4 or 5 cloths of, you know, the microfiber, and then clean it, and completely wipe it off, and then you dry it. Then you dry it, and that plate is very clean. And now, because the contamination is a problem now, so you must be extremely careful. In the same solution, you can soak your vegetables. But for soaking vegetables, you can use directly, you know, say in 1 liter water, you can keep 1 teaspoon of sodium bicarbonate, and then you can soak your vegetables overnight. They get alkalized and no bacteria will survive, and those vegetables are very good for cooking. For cooking, 13.5 to 14.5 pH is fine, no problem at all. You can use it. But use little bit of salt also in it. Or lemon also, put 1 teaspoon of lemon. But it has to be alkali pH only. So decontaminate your vegetables, decontaminate your surfaces of the eating vessels, and decontaminate yourself properly. Now again and again they are telling, you know, so 20 seconds you have to wash, and use the, what is the best, your hand wash solution doesn't have, that cannot give you the lather. So it only uses the soap base. There are so many kinds of the soap bases. Hand wash, body wash soap base is different. Shampoo's soap base is different, chemical is different, and your hand soap base is different. Very inferior quality. You will get as low as, you know, so a 10 cents, 20 cents, 1 liter soap solution you will get. But that soap solution cannot remove now coronavirus, let me tell you. Now if you want to really wash your hands, and now you use shampoo base soap solution, two kinds you will get. One is already polymerized, that looks like silky, that also you can use. But the best is so non-silky version, which is not, where they have not added any chemical polymer. And so that shampoo base is a transparent, clear, high dense viscous, and high viscous, and you know, so low viscous, high density, and that shampoo base solution, soap solution you use for hand wash. And a drop of it generates so much of foam in your hands. And for you to get rid of that soap solution, minimum time it will take is 20 seconds, I can tell you. Because still it feels soapy. Because your soap solution is not good quality, and the moment you put the water, the soap solution is gone. Whether it is a hot water, whether it is a hard water, whether it is a soft water. I am talking about even hard water also. You use the same, a very high quality shampoo soap base, and then you just put 1 drop or 2 drops into hand and rub it, and it will take 20 seconds for you to clean your hands. Now the requirement for the COVID, the decontamination level is very high demand now. That's the reason now you have to, the same soap solution doesn't work. The same kind of disinfectant will not. Why lather that? Because the foam reduces surface tension and the cell membrane of the cell membrane gets ruptured. Cell membrane. So what is the soap pH? It is alkaline. 8.5 pH, 9 pH. So in that alkaline environment, it won't survive. You know, it dissolves. And not only because of all, that's why the best quality of the, if it's diluted, it's diluted. Its concentration has come down. So most of the companies, what they do, they dilute the soap solution. It happens. So prepare. Yes. Now, best quality shampoo you have used now, 1 month, 2 months, so what is there? Use the shampoo for your hand wash, if you don't get one. So don't use ordinary hand wash. So use good hand wash. Shampoo for your hand wash. No problem. So lot of lather will come. You can see. But not silky. Silky one also if you have, it's okay. But you see where you will get good frothing or good lather you will get or not. Check. It should give lot of lather. Bubbles. So it is also, I'm just telling you, standards means for everything is a standard. Just now I told you hand wash. Similarly sanitizer. So sanitizer, only 75%, 80% only will work. 65% enough they say. But I am telling you 75% to 80%. And use glycerin. And use little bit of, yes, 3% hydrogen peroxide of what quality? Hydrogen peroxide. And glycerin, natural glycerin of highest quality. Bioproduced glycerin, naturally extracted glycerin if you use. That is the best, it keeps your hands wet. It won't damage. Everywhere there is a science. Everywhere yoga, the exploring the truth will help. Your truth should not be explored based on someone's review or delusion. And when you read commentaries of the yoga books are interpretation, yoga translations, what you read, books now contemporary authors, you are simply reading one's perception. And you have, that's why you have to go to the Moola Grantha. You have to go perception free based reading only is encouraged. Otherwise, it is like a novel and you fall in love with the author. That's fiction. Even yoga books are like fiction now. It's far away from the reality. So yoga, there is no you. That's why the tradition is standard. Never read someone's perception, because your perception, it influences, it conditions your mind. That's how you start loving one particular author and you start loving particular musician, and already you are deluded, now you are adding more delusion. That's all. You will not, that any delusion, it will prevent you to see the reality. The life is a reality. COVID is a reality. This moment is a reality. Delusion can never be a reality. Always train yourself to see the reality, to work with the reality, to explore the reality, and everything is only the truth, everything should be only reality. This entire class, I am just trying to show you, and what is the importance of a standard. Knowing the, not the standards outside, workplace standards you know, your furniture standards you do know, but the, they all will not be helpful, in any way helpful for your health and happiness. And what is helpful is knowing the standards of the mind called spiritual standards. And samadhi standards, enlightenment standards, yoga standards, asana standards. So every input, food standards, so what? Any nutrient you give, what is that nutrient standard? Don't just go by the methodology that, what I eat it as a nutrition, you know, it is enough, I don't want to take anything. You only suffer. So never do a perception-based statement. Never think perception-based. By default, we are deluded. Matadrupam pradishtayam mithyajnanam viparyayam mithyajnanam. By default, all of us, we are deluded already. And the delusion, our journey of yoga means the delusion to the reality. The journey is from delusion to the reality. The journey is from imperfection to the perfection. Impurity to the purity. From duality to the singularity. So that's the way we look at it. So today, the lesson. So how the lemon juice and how this solution has to be prepared, I have shown you. So keep a pH paper, all my yoga students in India, you know, whether they purchased or not, as few of them purchased, but I have already given them the pH paper. A guru, when I have given them, almost 4 months back, 3 months back, 4 months back, I have given the pH paper. Why we have given them? So because you see, it is always useful in the kitchen, always useful, because your body is working between 7.35 to 7.44 pH. So everything, every input, how much acidic it is it too acidic, it will take away your teeth enamel. Then immediately you have to wash, you have to rinse your mouth. Always remember the pH is a guiding criteria. Too alkaline is bad and too acidic is bad. So it will help you in taking precautions. And what about, so if you do toilet cleaner, etc., that is having normality, high concentrated acids there. So pH, when you say, it is only for less than one normal, less than one normal concentration, less than 1 gram mole concentrations, only for dilute concentrations only pH is the scale used. Dilute concentrations itself, you have so much of variation, understand? That's why your body is working at a very dilute concentration of 7.35 to 7.45 pH, at a very, very dilute level. So we should be very careful about that. Now, you have seen me sitting in Angushta Vajrasana. Now, for all this time, I explained. You know. So now, let me keep these things away and let us do some yoga. Yoga means not simply a practice. Yoga means ahara, vihara, food and exercise, vyavahara, how to conduct and suvichara and how to meditate, what is the meditation, to change the horoscope, entire methodology. It is a holistic approach. If you practice only, if you study only one subject in the school, they won't promote you. You have to study all the subjects. Where your child is studying in a secondary school or a senior school, you should know that your child is studying 6 to 7 subjects. Similarly, yoga means all the subjects are very important. It's not one subject. By studying one subject, your student, your child will not be able to complete education. It is only specialization begins at one level, but until then, all understanding of all the subjects, all the limbs is very important in yoga also, at primary level, at secondary level, and we need to understand all the primary subjects, all the primary limbs of the yoga, but that is not happening. You are only learning one small limb of the yoga called asana, that's all. The world is going behind the asana. You are becoming a soldier, you are becoming a fighter, you are becoming aggressive. Yoga goal is not that. Yoga is, asana is the smallest part of your entire field of the mind compared to your body, in the body also, and the way you, the role of the asana is very, very small, not even a 5% role, understand? So your life of 40 years should not go, what is that 5% should not go for waste, should not be wasted for that 5% reality. And for your cause of suffering, the body is only 5%. Your cause of suffering because of your delusion, you do not know the standards. If you know the standards, and if your living standard changes, if you are living, your food becomes scientific, not perception based. And then, yoga helps. Otherwise, you do any yoga, but these standards are not changed, and this yoga doesn't produce any benefit for you. It is like exercise, that's all. So yoga is not exercise. Yoga is holistic way of training the unconscious mind. So now, let us get into an Angushta Vajrasana. Let me prepare my legs and before I go into the asana part. And free your legs, free your feet in frontal flexion, so in frontal plane, and using lateral direction, so moving your legs in the lateral direction, freeing them. Proximal and dorsal, freeing them, distal and proximal, movements, two movements are allowed in frontal plane, So free your limbs, free your legs. Now, so today we practice a medium resistance, a low resistance, and zero resistance, and one round of it. And gently inhale, come up like this, and exhale your arms down, free your arms. Your right foot here, so your left foot here. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, and exhale, inhale, and exhale, inhale, and exhale, inhale, and drop your arms and free your arms. And keep your left foot perpendicular to the right foot. Inhale and exhale, inhale and exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, gently drop your arms, free your arms, and free your lumbar sacrum. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Free your lumbar sacrum and drop your shoulders. Free your shoulders and gently inhale, exhale. And now, so we go into the down. Inhale and free your trunk. Exhale and go down. Inhale and come here and prepare your seat. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Free your shoulders. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Just do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Pushing your heel downward is very important. If you don't push your heel downward, your foot should be like this at 75 degrees, not like this. This one will put load on your L1, L2. Your foot should be downward and then your spine goes up. Then you won't harm back. The major blunder what we do in upper planks is feet like this should never be. It should be like this. Then your back is protected. Inclined. Ekam dvenam trinam chaturam pancham shadam saptam. And bring your knees down. And now free your back. Ekam dvenam trinam chaturam pancham shadhamam saptamam. Once again, if you want, here and free your leg. Ekam dvenam trinam chaturam pancham shadham saptam. And gently bring your right leg here. Ekam dvenam trinam chaturam pancham shadham saptam. And gently free your shoulders, free your back. You are ready for next upper plank. The same upper plank also you can repeat. So other plank we do. So elbow down dog we do. So cross your fingers. Inhale. Ekam dvenam trinam chaturam pancham shadham saptam. Bring your leg down and lift your right leg. Ekam dvenam trinam chaturam
panchama shradhama saptama,
and push your seat back. Stay there. Ekam dvena trena jatura panchama shradhama saptama. Elbow plank. Ekam dvena trena jatura panchama shadhama saptama.
Free your leg. Ekam dvena trena jatura panchama shadhama saptama.
Bring your feet down. Roll your seat. Free your seat. Inhale. Exhale. Lift your legs up. Free your back.
Ekam dvena three, four, five, six, seven.
Inhale. Exhale. Roll your seat comfortably. Like this. And gently free your shoulders. Free your shoulders. Free your legs like this. Inhale. Exhale. And left side. Right side.
Ekam vena.
Inhale. Exhale.
Ekam vena. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Inhale. Exhale.
1, 2, 3, 4.
And raising your legs up and freeing it. Bring it down. Rolling your seat. Inhale. Exhale. Gently pushing your seat back here and dropping your legs down.
Ekam dvena three, four.
Inhale. Inhale. Madhyama. Right side your neck. Waist on left side.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Inhale. 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 And exhale again. Exhale again. Inhale. Up. If required, free your shoulders. Now up. Lower plank. Inhale. Lower plank. Your elbows close to the ribcage. Like this.
Ekam dvenam trinam chaturam panchama shadam saptam.
If you want to go up. Going to the up.
Ekam dvenam trinam chaturam panchama shadhamam saptamam. Ekam dvenam trinam chaturam panchama shadhamam saptamam. Ekam dvenam trinam chaturam panchama shadhamam saptamam. Ekam dvenam trinam chaturam panchama shadam saptamam.
Relax. Very effective. Free your legs. Cross your legs. Leave it free.
Ekam dvenam trinam chaturam panchama shadam saptamam. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Gently bring your legs down. Roll your seat. Happily. Free it completely. Again, legs up. Free your shoulders. And free your shoulders. Freeing your neck important. Left side, right side.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Inhale, exhale.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Inhale, exhale.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Lift your legs up, drop them down. Roll your seat. Easily. Gently free your shoulders. free your shoulders, gently
lift your legs up.
Another resistance exercise. Ekam dvenam trinam jaturam 5, 6, 7. Inhale, exhale, gently lift your neck up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Inhale, lift your knees up. Inhale, lift your knees up. Inhale, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up. Lift your left leg, lift your right leg. Time to free your back once again after resistance. Push your back like this. Extensor, hip extensor completely, and leave your neck free between the shoulders. Your shoulders completely relaxed and your neck is in between, drawn in freely like a tortoise. Resting down, completely free. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Freeing it and freeing your shoulders. Back, Marjalasana. Coming here, freeing your back. Leisurely, leisurely freeing your shoulders. Leaving your back free and gently. And freeing your leg once again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Gently here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And gently bring your forearms down and free your seat. Inhale, free your shoulders, ready for down dog. Inhale, and your heel touching down and your waistline back, look between the shoulders. Inhale, exhale. Ekam dvenam 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Inhale, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Bring your left leg down, raise your right leg. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Inhale, gently bring down, push your seat back. Inhale, exhale, inhale. I gently walk back like this. Inhale and free, bring your knees down, free your shoulders, free your shoulders, Angusta Padasana, free your shoulders and free your knees, free your back, inhale. Either you can go back into supine or you can go up into the up posture, free your knees, lift your arms up, inhale. And come up. Once again, see this second cycle and free your shoulders. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. And now, so going down again, so now doing the posture. So into resistance based, median resistance, low resistance, we are doing zero resistance always. Now, going into inhale and exhale and gently inhale. And your heel down, stay there, and gently go down, stay there, inhale, and gently lie down, free your shoulders, free your back, gently, and gently lift your chest up, inhale, exhale, drop your legs down, inhale, lift your knees up, left side, right side, and gently, and push your seat back. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. Inhale, left side, gently inhale, lift your right leg and drop down.
Inhale and gently jump to the front and gently free your shoulders, free your shoulders, free your shoulders, free your shoulders. Very important. Or you're here, free your back, free your knees, free your back and gently go into the front. See, this is very important when you do that, otherwise your neck back problems you start developing by doing down dog. And free your shoulders, gently free your knees and raise your arms up. Inhale, up. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Now once again, inhale, exhale and gently inhale. Inhale, go back. If you can't jump, go slowly, no problem. Inhale, stay there. Inhale, lower plank. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, up dog. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, down dog. Inhale, down dog. Inhale and jump. And free your shoulders, free your back and relax here. Free your shoulders, free your back. Free your legs if required. Free your legs completely. And you bring your arms here. Inhale, arms up. Inhale. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Once again. Inhale, so if required, lumbar sacrum, free your muscle. Ekam dve drena jatura panjama shadama saptama. Once again, inhale, exhale. Now inhale and gently exhale, lie down. Free your legs, gently free your legs, free your legs, roll your seat, inhale, exhale, once again, up, inhale, exhale, bring your legs down, up, down, inhale, and gently exhale, lift your left leg once, drop it, and lift your right leg up, and drop it, and gently drop it, inhale, and jump. And free again your shoulders. Front to back, back to front. Free your shoulders, free your knees. Inhale, exhale, arms up. Inhale, trunk up. And drop your arms down. Free your shoulders. Free your back, free your back. Free your back. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Inhale. Now the next one, so we do so low resistance and low resistance, low resistance, low intensity. Look at inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. Free your shoulders. Observe the sequence now. Free your shoulders. Inhale, exhale, inhale, free your trunk, free your trunk, and free your back, free your back. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Inhale, exhale, see this. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale, inhale, free your shoulders, free your knees, inhale, exhale, inhale, observe, exhale, now once again, inhale, exhale, as soon as you come down, legs lifted, freeing the back, inhale, exhale, total relaxation. Inhale, up down. Exhale, inhale. Not necessary even this. Inhale, exhale. Free your shoulders, free your knees. inhale, and raise your arms up, inhale, up. Free your trunk, free your trunk. Inhale, once again, inhale, exhale, easy, inhale, and free your shoulders, inhale. See this, exhale, inhale, and free your shoulders, and free your knees, exhale, free your shoulders, inhale, exhale, free your knees, exhale, inhale, free your shoulders, exhale, drop your shoulders, inhale, up, exhale, free your arms, inhale, exhale, free your shoulders, free your back, free your knees, free your shoulders, exhale, inhale, relax. Now, cross your legs, free your legs, inhale, exhale, gently, and bring your legs down, roll your seat, free your seat, inhale, exhale, gently up, free your neck, relaxed way, do it and drop them, inhale, up, exhale, and back, free your shoulders, free your back, go down, relax. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, inhale, exhale, and gently off dog, and push your seat back, and free your shoulders, free your neck, relax, inhale, exhale, elbow off down, free your seat, free your back, and then gently coming into Vagra tiger posture, freeing the tiger walking in the jungle, Vagra Bala Chalana, and free your shoulders, and big cat posture, freeing your shoulders, freeing your neck, inhale, and gently back, inhale, and gently moving in the front, free your shoulders, and your back, your neck, so better relax, inhale, exhale, left leg back, inhale, exhale,
exhale and drop your arms down and bring your legs to the front. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, and gently bring your right knee here. Inhale, gently, palms up, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, and drop your arms, free your arms, bring your knees here, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, turn around. Ekam dvenam renam jaduram panchamashad saptam. Prayer postures called Pratanasana, many postures, is the best way to free. And now push your back to the front and free your back. Zero rest, all these are zero resistance, freeing entire back, every muscle again, every pore, because we have done medium intensity, low intensity, medium resistance and medium resistance and low resistance and low intensity yoga. So that's good for the heart, and we have gone, touched up to medium resistance today, free your shoulders. So if you can't jump, take your legs slowly, no problem at all. Free your feet and gently free your shoulders. Freeing the spine is very, very important. Very, there is no muscle, there is no cell that is not left out, that is not supplied oxygen. There is anabolic action, there is a catabolic action today. We are introduced, so contraction and relaxation. That is very, very important. Inhaling, exhaling. So at least twice in a week, and to this extent you can do, you know. And yes, intensity, little bit, like activity and box breathing intensity is good enough. Free your shoulders. This is also low intensity. Free your shoulders and free your back, free your back. Free your back and lie down. And so free your neck gently and lift your seat up and free your back. Free your back gently, bring your seat down. Again, so go into the Trikotasana, free your shoulders and come into the front and free your legs, free your lower lumbar region, lower the seat area, free your shoulders. Inhale, exhale, and gently go behind on the elbows. Inhale, exhale, and gently free your back, free your back. Now gently freeing your legs, there's a time to relax and lie down and do the dharana. Inhale and gently lie down. So keep your legs apart and your feet apart. And your concentration, your heart as a vertices of a triangle, your both feet as a base of the triangle, and your center of mass of a triangle is down the navel, and the L5 S1 region down, and L5 S1 region, and there you concentrate and free your shoulders and free entire body. Shayanam. Body.
Gently, gently, urdhvam shirasam pujayami
Free your entire body, free your legs, free your feet. Close your hands, open your hands. Raise your knees up, free your back. Free your back and bring your hands onto the chest. Free your shoulders, free your shoulders. Inhale, bring your arms into the front. Inhale, elbows back and free your shoulders. Gently. Gently go in the front, free your shoulders, free your back. That's how you need to relax when you do medium resistance or low resistance, and you must relax completely at the end. You must take your system to least state of energy and we end with the prayer. Sarve sant nera sorrow,
Sarvasya Sarve Santu Nera you.
Oh, first thing, have a nice day and a healthy day and a happy day. Enjoy. May you be protected. Namaste.